Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you all the different ways you can set an image for your contacts on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So in the Contacts app, you can set a picture for every contact. Originally, you could set a photo that you have of that person. Or you could set it up to use some sort of standard icon. But over the years, Apple has added more and more options. And now in macOS Monterey, we have some really cool things that you can do with these pictures. So here I am in the Contacts app. And if I go to Edit or to simply click right here, I can immediately go to edit the image used for that person. Look at all the options I could choose from. So let's look at some old standards first. You can go to Photos here and choose something from the Photos app. You could even choose from your favorite photos, from shared albums, or any regular album. So you can quickly dig down to see what you can use. I can select a photo like this one, and I could go over here, enlarge it, recenter it, and click Save, and it will put it as the image for this contact. And of course, if I'm doing this in iCloud, which you could see I am, then this is going to sync across to my iPhone, my iPad, my other Macs, and I'll see this image whenever that person calls, sends me a message, or I do something else that involves this contact. But there's so much more that you can do. Let's say you don't have a photo of them. Well, you can use camera here to take a photo right now. So if you have them with you, you could take a picture. Now, if you're doing this on your iPhone or iPad, it's really easy to hold it up and take a picture of them. But you can do it using the camera on your Mac as well. Now, if you don't have a picture of them, you can create a picture, kind of, by going to Memoji. A Memoji you would usually use for yourself to create kind of an avatar, something that kind of looks like you, that you could use in a variety of situations. But you could do this for other people as well. So you could click the plus button here, and then you can design, using all of these different categories here, a Memoji that looks like that person, or maybe it doesn't look like that person. You can create whatever you want. So you can see now I put a lot of detail in for the Memoji. Click Done, and then we'll add it right there. And now I can zoom in a little bit here and position it if I want. I can also go to Pose, and this will bring up some predefined poses here that I could use instead of just looking straight at the camera. Now, if you're on an iPhone or iPad, you actually can select the first one and then use your face to actually pose anything that you want. So mouth open, close, head tilted to the side, a smirk, anything you want, you can put in here and create it as you like. Then you can go to Style, and that just sets a background color there. That might help when you're viewing in Contacts, if you have a color that kind of matches various groups of people, or friends, coworkers, that kind of thing. And then you can click Save, and now that will be used. So if you like, you can design one of these for everybody. Note that you don't have to use just one of these. You can also use one of the Animoji, which are the little predefined animal faces right here. And you can use those for people as well. Now, here's another option. You can go to Emoji. And here you can pick one of these emoji right here, like the sailboat. You can set a style, which is just the background color like before. Or you could click plus and then choose any emoji you want. So you can go up here to the top and search, or you can select one that you want. And we'll use that instead. So of course that adds hundreds and hundreds of different emoji that you can use instead of an image. And this really helps when it's a company contact, not a person, or maybe the person is somebody specific. Like maybe your plumber, you can use an emoji that represents plumbing or handyman or something like that. So for instance, for this one, I can go in here, I can choose emoji and click there and then search for something like this and maybe set the style blue for water. And then I got something that works a little bit better than that generic one. Now also here under suggestions, you still have the old icons. So you could choose one of those if there's one that you like. It'll also show you recent things that you've set up here. And what if you want to use a real custom image, like a file? You can take any standard image file format, drag and drop it right onto this, and then you could adjust it to fit in the circle as you like. And now you're using that instead. And finally, the last one is monogram. So if you just want to use some letters, you can. You can pick a color set here and I'll use it. But the great thing is that you can customize. So you don't have to settle for initials or two letters of a company name or something like that. You can, you know, create whatever you want. You can even use some standard punctuation as well, like that or something like that. So now you have a lot of options for creating these little images that go with your contacts. Now you may not want to create unique images for everybody. It takes a lot of time. But for at least the people that you get messages from all the time. After all, look at my messages app here with just the gray circles with the letters in it. It would be a lot nicer if I took the time for at least these people to add in something more unique. So now you can see how it's a little easier to pick people out in the messages app. And the same system is present if you go into System Preferences and then Apple ID, and then you find your own icon here. You can click Edit and you find the same options here for creating the image that represents you. And of course in macOS Monterey, if you choose a Memoji, it will actually animate when you look at the login screen. So I'll choose this one right here to use for me. I'll save. I'll go to the lock screen. And you can see there I am, and it's actually looking at the cursor. And as I enter in the password, it pays attention. So while creating custom images for each of your contacts and yourself is something you might have skipped in the past, I think now it's something that's useful to do and can also be fun. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.